I'm sorry to see there is a possibility we may lose some momentum on helping to level the playing field with China in our economic relationship due to the situation in North Korea. We have some hopeful news. U.S., South Korea, and Japan are hopefully going to be convening trilateral talks on North Korea. This was an announcement made by the South Korean Ministry of Defense. Meanwhile, North Korea is still warning that thermonuclear war may break out any moment. The Chinese spokesperson is saying that this is maybe pouring oil on the fire, so we'll just have to see what is going on with that. But there's also an economic aspect of this, and of course, this is a reversal that Donald Trump has done, saying that there's no currency manipulation going on by China. Understand, currency manipulation is just one of the things that China has done to attack America's economy. We have the Chamber of Commerce and Pat Buchanan pointing this out. Two people who are two groups, a group and a person who are not usually on the same side of this issue. The Chamber of Commerce says that Trump needs to use every arrow in his quiver against the unfair advantages that China has. And what are these arrows that are in their quiver? What is the China price that allows them to produce things at 30 to 50% cheaper than we can here in America? Well, they have obviously lower labor prices. They have low wages. They have no safety for their employees. They protect their own markets very vigorously. Here you have the Chinese President Xi coming out and saying, we've got to have open free trade, just like Henry Kissinger told me. He taught us all of this, how to do this, right? We have to have free trade, and yet they are the ones who are the most rigorous about protectionism. The same people that are preaching that we have to open our markets, we have to open our gates to their goods. They're going to protect their internal markets. They also pirate copyrights. That's a key part of the China price. And of course, there's no restriction on environmental regulations, but we have restrictions that are put on us with the Paris Climate Treaty. We're going to have far more stringent controls put on our industry, and that's going to happen at a much earlier date before they have even minor restrictions put on their industry. One of the things that happened last week, remember, they buy a lot of coal from North Korea. See, the Chinese can still buy massive amounts of coal. Obama didn't have a problem with that. But I thought it was global warming. No. They're only concerned about it if America and Europe are warming the globe. It's not a problem when China does it or India does it. They're given a special pass on that. And evidence of that was the fact that China had, as trying to get North Korea to get a little bit more rational, they said, we're going to stop taking your coal shipments. And then last week, as a gesture to Trump, when he said, oh, you're not currency manipulators anymore. Right. When he said, you're not currency manipulators anymore, they said, all right, we're going to just send those, that fleet of ships carrying coal, we're going to send them back to North Korea. We're done. We're not going to take that. They're still going to burn coal. They just won't buy it from North Korea. So we look at a couple of these different things, the subsidies of their own industries, the low labor prices, the currency manipulation. We're going to have our Federal Reserve manipulate our currency. That's the strategy they're going to take. They're not going to say that China is manipulating their currency. They're going to give them a pass on that. And then Trump wants the Federal Reserve to weaken the dollar. They're really good at that. They're really good at weakening the dollar. You know, the Federal Reserve was created 104 years ago, same time as the income tax, because that's when they changed our tax structure. Prior to that, it was heavily skewed toward taxes at the border and not having internal taxes. As a matter of fact, Jefferson was proud of the fact when he gave his second inaugural address, he said, we have eliminated all internal taxations by eliminating unnecessary offices. So you go back to a constitutionally sized government, you can run a constitutionally sized government off of taxes at the border. And Jefferson said, what farmer, what laborer, what mechanic knows a tax man? Well, in America today, all of us know the tax man, don't we? But they didn't at Jefferson's time. How did that change? Well, that changed when we got the Federal Reserve and we got the income tax in 1913. And we've lost over 99% of the purchasing power of the U.S. dollar in that amount of time as well. That's the legacy of the income tax, the legacy of the Federal Reserve. And now Donald Trump, who criticized, who said maybe we need to audit the Fed. He criticized Janet Yellen. Now he's saying, well, I think Janet Yellen is pretty good. We're going to use her to weaken our currency because we're going to pretend that the Chinese are not manipulating their currency. So the Chamber of Commerce is saying right now, basically, we're recommending to President Trump, everything you have in your quiver, please use every arrow possible with the understanding that some of these points of leverage that you're using will be counterproductive to us. They say that, of course, Trump promised to curb U.S. trade deficits with China. They've reached $347 billion. Not a problem now. Not a problem. We will give them a free pass as long as we can engage in military adventurism abroad. Now, according to the chairman of the Chamber of Commerce, Beijing can offer subsidies of billions of dollars to domestic competitors. That's part of the China price. He said, I'm sorry to see there is a possibility we may lose some momentum on helping to level the playing field with China in our economic relationship due to the situation in North Korea if there is some kind of a trade-off. Well, you can believe that there is a trade-off. Pat Buchanan pointed it out. He said, quoted President Trump, who said, why would I call China a currency manipulator when they're working with us on the North Korean problem? So he said, right there, we see that Trump, who once seemed to understand how America had taken us to the cleaners during and after the Cold War, while allies supported us diplomatically, they piled up huge trade surpluses at our expense, and they became virtual free riders off of the U.S. defense effort. And so that's Patrick Buchanan pointing that out. He said a continuing crisis on the peninsula with Trump and the U.S. relying on Beijing's help could leave Xi in the catbird seat. And now that North Korea has declared its goal to be building missiles with nuclear warheads that could hit all U.S. bases in Asia, even California, the clock is running for the White House. Tillerson and Pence have said that they're running out of patience. But the question is this, how did we get to this point? How did we get to this? It's not Obama's fault, okay? I mean, you're not going to blame everything on Obama. This is just as much Bush's fault and the Republicans' fault. This has been going on for 64 years. And many people have said, well, other people could have done something about it. Now Donald Trump is going to have to do something about it. But how did we get into the Korean War? We got into the Korean War because we decided we needed to be the world's policeman. We decided that the first Americans who put America first, the founders of our country, didn't know what they were talking about when they said, we don't go abroad seeking monsters to destroy. And a good example of this is the Turkey election that's happening. We got a civil war going on in Turkey, and it's spilling over onto our shores. The competition between Erdogan and Fethullah Gulen is spilling into Europe as well. This competition shows us something in Turkey. There's not always a good guy and a bad guy. Sometimes there's just two really bad guys. Both Erdogan and Fethullah Gulen are not secularists. They want to preside over a caliphate, a global caliphate, if they will. And so as we see their influence spread throughout Europe and throughout the United States, and as we've seen in other places where we go in to do regime change, it always backfires. Even if we win a war, we don't win the peace. This whole thing about acting as the world's policeman is doomed to failure. Now, when they said that we don't go abroad seeking monsters to destroy, they were talking about getting involved in European wars. We saw what happened with World War I. That was an unnecessary war for us to get involved in. What would they have said about the Middle East situation? I mean, even Ronald Reagan, after the bombing in Beirut, said, I'm going to get my troops out of here. And he got his troops out of there. But we continue to go in, even though we see these regime changes like we had in Libya, create a much worse problem. As Pat Buchanan said, why 64 years after the Korean War, a quarter century after the Cold War, are we still obliged to go to war to defend South Korea from a North with one half of the South Korean population and with 3% of its gross domestic product? Well, I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why, Pat. It's because we have put ourselves out there as protectors. So it's now no longer an issue between North and South Korea. They're coming after us. We're the target now. Because we have said, we're going to shut down all the monsters everywhere. We know exactly what we're doing. No, we don't. You know, why should their nuclear missiles be America's primary responsibility? Why don't the South Koreans do something about it? Why do we have to be the world's policemen? It is not going to work. And now we have a situation where instead of following an America First policy instead of listening to the first Americans, the founders of our country. We now have a situation where we got people like John McCain calling Rand Paul a Russian agent because he merely says that we ought to have a debate before we set up another tripwire with a tiny country in Europe, before we set up another possibility where we would have to go to war to defend them. Can't we see where this is all leading? Can't we see that this is a failed policy that's been 64 years in the making? Can't we put America first for once? Perhaps not.
Let's go to Devin in Florida. Devin in Florida, you're on the air.
Great. Hey, thank you so much. Listen, I have bought your products, and I got to say, they're amazing.
Thank
Anyone
you.
Who's on the fence, buy it, because I've got Caveman, Superman Vitality, Secret 12, Vitamin Mineral Fusion. I've got the body armor.
Wow, thank you.
Wow.
You're the top of the list that makes it all possible. Which nutraceutical does you like best?
I really like the Vitamin Mineral Fusion, to be honest.
That's amazing.
Really incredible. I drank it in the morning, and I swear to you, I felt incredible. Like, I haven't felt in a week. My morning was fantastic, and I love you guys. I love the InfoWars crew. And I just want to, I want to take this opportunity to tell anybody out there who's on the fence, just buy it. You will love it. I'm telling you, I've never bought a bad product.
What you find in our news is the same thing you find in our products at InfoWarsLife.com. It's a win-win, InfoWarsLife.com.